Ladies and gentlemen, the academic procession will enter shortly. You are kindly requested to stand.
Bomma le botate, molokoloko wa diruteri o tla tsena ka nako ya kopana, le gopelwa go ema.
Dames en here, die akademiese prosesie sal binnekort inbeweeg. U word versoek om asseblief op te staan.
By the power vested in me, I hereby constitute this assembly as a legal congregation of the University of Pretoria. During this assembly, degrees and diplomas, with all the associated rights and privileges, will be conferred and awarded to the candidates whose names appear in the program. Please take your seats. Ladies and gentlemen, we request you to join us in silent prayer or meditation to give thanks for the achievements of our graduates. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, as Vice Chancellor and Principal of the University of Pretoria, I extend a hearty word of welcome to you at this graduation ceremony. I would like to welcome specifically the following people or categories of people. The recipient of the honorary doctorate, Mr. Laurie DePenard, Dean of the Faculty of Economic and Management Sciences, Professor Margaret Chitiga Mabugu, the Executive Director, Finance and Business Initiatives, Professor Carolina Kurunhoff, Chairpersons of Schools, Heads of Departments, Directors, Emeriti and Honorary Professors, and other lecturers, their partners and spouses. Representative of the Student Representative Council, who will present the SRC Academic Honorary Colors. All persons to whom degrees and diplomas will be conferred and awarded this morning. All spouses, parents, partners, and other parties, as well as dignitaries we may not be aware of. I now request the Dean to introduce to me the candidate for the honorary doctorate.
I have the honor to introduce to you Mr. Lauritz Lancer Dipener for the conferment of the degree Doctor of Commerce Honorius Causa. Laurie Dipener studied at the University of Pretoria, where he obtained an M.Com in accounting and then qualified as a chartered accountant in 1973. In 1977, together with two partners, he founded Rand Consolidated Investments Pty, or RCI for short, a company specializing in project finance for public utility companies and municipalities. RCI's initial capital was only 10,000 rands. From this modest beginning, Laurie and his co-founders built First Rand into the largest financial services group on the African continent by market capitalization over the next 40 years. It was achieved through rapid organic growth, creating and expanding well-known startups such as Outsurance and Discovery, and acquiring and merging with household brands like First National Bank, Rand Merchant Bank, West Bank, and Momentum Life. During the tenure of his 40-year career in the financial services industry, Laurie served as a chairman of the following companies in the group: Momentum Life, Outsurance, Discovery, First National Bank, Rand Merchant Bank, First Rand. From his modest foundation in 1977, the original business co-founded by him, First Rand, has grown in 40 years into one of the largest financial services groups in South Africa, employing 45,000 people with total assets of 2 trillion rand. Laurie served in the governing bodies of various educational institutions, including more than 2 decades as a member of the Council of the University of Pretoria. He served as president of Business Leadership of South Africa for 2 years and chaired the Center for Development and Enterprise, one of South Africa's best known think tanks, for 15 years. Laurie co-sponsors the Laurie Dippener First Rand Postgraduate Scholarship, which annually awards bursaries to South African students for postgraduate studies abroad in any discipline at an international university of their choice. He was voted Sunday Times Businessman of the Year in 1998. In 2014, he received the Sunday Times Lifetime Achiever Award. Mr. Vice Chancellor and Principal, I request you to confer the honorary doctorate on the candidate.
I hereby confer the degree of Doctor of Commerce Honoris Causa on Mr. Laurie Lansa Dippener. Congratulations. I have the honor of requesting Mr. Laurie Lansa Dippener to address the assembly.
Vice Chancellor and Principal, Professor Coupe, members of the executive, Dean of the Faculty, Professor Margaret Chitiga Mabugu, faculty, staff, ladies and gentlemen. It's an immense privilege for me, to receive this honor from one of the leading education institutions in the country. Built over more than 100 years of academic, scientific tradition and leading the future through its teaching, learning, and pioneering research. I would like to express my deep gratitude for this recognition. My association with the university goes back to 1967. That's 56 years ago. And when I started studies here and continued until I retired from the University Council a few years ago. It gives me great pleasure here to stand before you today. I've chosen as the theme of my address, What Stays the Same. I'm sure you've all attended talks that have emphasized how technology will dramatically change our lives in the future. It is true, we'll see driverless cars, artificial intelligence apps that can write speeches or legal opinions for you on any topic, and more technological advances. It is true, we will experience huge technological change in the future that will impact us dramatically. But what will stay the same? I believe what will stay the same is the importance of values. One of the most critical success factors in our group over 40 years has been the fact that we have been a value-driven and not a rule-driven organization. If any of you ever visit Rand Merchant Bank, one of the companies in the group, you will find prominently displayed in the entrance hall the RMB Book of Rules. It is quite a thick book, and if you flip through the pages, you will find every page is blank. But on the inside cover, you will find a statement of Rand Merchant Bank values. It's not that we do not believe in rules, it's just that we think values are more important than rules. We have many parents here today, and I'm sure you will agree that you cannot brace your child's upbringing on a plethora of rules. You need to arm your children with a sound value system to guide them through life. You cannot dream up enough rules to cover every eventuality your children will encounter. The value system you will have instilled in them will be their guiding light. My experience is that you can have rules and policies, as many as you like. If there's not a sound value system present in the organization as a foundation for those rules, you will achieve very limited success trying to enforce the rules. Just think of what's happening in many departments of government and state-owned enterprises. Why are sound values so important to individuals and institutions, whether it be a corporation, school, government, etc.? What is the reward for getting a sound or having a sound value system? The reward is summed up in one word: trust. So what is trust? It's defined in the dictionary as a firm belief in the honesty, truthfulness, justice, and power of a person. What are the characteristics of trust? What is the type of behavior that we expect from leaders if they are to be trusted? What we look for are the following characteristics: transparency, justice, fairness, consistency, predictability. I believe it's very difficult to lead people, in fact impossible to lead them, if they do not trust you. It is not words that build trust, but actual deeds. A deed is worth 1,000 words. The best example of that is what happened in 1995 Rugby World Cup, when all South Africa experienced a miracle. So a typical South African rugby crowd of that time would at best and diplomatically be described as right of center. But on that day, we saw Mr. Mandela entering the field wearing the number 6 Springbok jersey. The entire right of center crowd rose in unison and gave him a standing ovation, chanting, "Nelson, Nelson, Nelson." At the time, it was just a year into our new democracy, and everything was still quite fragile. And the Springbok emblem was also under threat at the time. But it was a gesture that made the invaluable contribution to laying a foundation of trust for our Rainbow Nation to build on. As a gesture of reconciliation, it was critically important. Now, I'm glad I lived long enough to experience that miracle. But we've also seen much of the trust created by Mr. Mandela being dissipated by subsequent leaders whose value systems and deeds have largely destroyed Mr. Mandela's legacy. As a consequence, we're a bit of a troubled country. Now, trust makes the world function. Think of it. You step into an aeroplane, you trust that they've maintained it properly, that the pilots are properly qualified, and that the pilot will get you to your destination. You deposit money with a bank, and you trust that they will return the deposit to you when you require it. So trust is a bit like oxygen. It's everywhere. It's all around us. And we all take it for granted until it's not there. And the absence of oxygen, just like the absence of trust, has dire consequences. Pretoria University is 100 years old. It would not have survived for that long if it was not built on a foundation of trust, supported by an unwavering commitment to its values. To conclude, you're all young, I was going to like to share four practical lessons from life with you graduates based on my own experience and experience of people I admire. The lessons, in essence, summarize the central themes of my address. The first practical piece of advice comes from Warren Buffett, who has accumulated one of the largest fortunes in the history of the world. He is unquestionably one of the most respected businessmen in the world. He is known as Mr. Clean in business and played a big role reassuring the American public that the New York Stock Exchange would not come crashing down after 9/11. When asked what the ingredients of his success were, he said, "As a child, even today, I read voraciously. I read everything in sight." Warren Buffett also has a business partner, Charlie Munger, who's 90 years old, an equally voracious reader, who said the following: "In my whole life, I've known no wise people who didn't read all the time." Second lesson: values are more important than rules. Thirdly, building trust is everything. Building trust in everything you do is sacrosanct. Values and trust are the foundation of a functional, decent society. Trust takes a lifetime to build, and it's destroyed in the blink of an eye. The building of trust between all the members of the Rainbow Nation is of critical importance at this juncture in the history of South Africa. We all need to play our part and build our future on a foundation of trust. And fourthly, always strive to occupy the moral high ground. If you allow yourself into the abyss of the moral low ground, you are doomed to a perpetual position of weakness and defensiveness. It is a very difficult position, if not impossible, from which to achieve success. Finally, my sincere congratulations to all of you gathered today on being capped and receiving your degree from one of South Africa's top universities. South Africa desperately needs your skills, and it remains a country where every one of you can make a difference to the destiny of South Africa. So please, all stay in this country and make it a difference. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you very much, Mr. Laurie Dipena. You are not only a pioneering South African, but a very inspiring person who has made a difference to our society, the world, and changed many people's lives. And you have done this under not always conditions where some would fold rather than soldier on. And your advice to our graduates and to all of us is deeply appreciated. Thank you. I now request the Dean to introduce to me candidates present whose names appear in the program.
Mr. Vice Chancellor and Principal, the supervisors will now introduce the doctoral candidates.
Mr. Vice Principal and Vice Chancellor and Principal, I introduce to you Chisava Juma, who has complied with the requirements for the degree Doctor of Philosophy with a thesis, visa requirements and destination choice, integrating the theory of planned behavior and the Stimulus Organism Response Model, prepared under the supervision of Prof. Annelie Douglas. In this thesis, Visa Requirements and Destination Choice, Integrating the Theory of Planned Behavior and the Stimulus Organism Model, the candidate investigated the relationships between visa requirements expectations, the emotions that are triggered as a result of the visa application process, and a tourist's intention to visit their destination of choice using the theory of planned behavior and the stimulus organism response model. Exploratory and confirmatory factor analysis and structural equation modeling were used to analyze the data. The study contributes by showing the direct influence of visa requirements expectations on a tourist's emotions and their intentions to visit their destination of choice. The study further illuminates the moderating role of visa requirements expectations and the mediating role of the emotions triggered by the visa application process. The results may be used to assist in convincing policymakers to formulate less restrictive visa policies that would encourage more tourists to visit their respective countries. Mr. Vice Chancellor and Principal, I request you to confer the degree on the candidate.
I hereby confer the degree of Doctor of Philosophy with all its associated rights and privileges on the candidate. Congratulations.
Mr. Vice Chancellor and Principal, I introduce to you Zinat Parekh, who has complied with the requirements for the degree Doctor of Philosophy with a thesis titled Exploring the Indigenous Beliefs of Black Africans in a South African Workplace, prepared under my supervision. The study investigated the accommodation of Black African beliefs in South African workplaces. The candidate investigated how Black Africans negotiate their professional and cultural identities within the workplace. Through semi-structured interviews conducted with Black African employees, the cultural challenges they experience was brought to the fore. The study revealed that ancestors, traditional healing, and witchcraft in the workplace were aspects which are alien in organizations. These elements resulted in employees working and reworking their cultural identities in adapting to workplace expectations. The study provides key insights and recommendations to employers and HR practitioners on how Black African employees can be accommodated and understood within the workplace. Mr. Vice Chancellor and Principal, I request you to confer the degree on the candidate.
I hereby confer the degree of Doctor of Philosophy with its all associated rights and privileges on the candidate. Congratulations.
Mr. Vice Chancellor and Principal, I introduce to you Jonathan Tumwebaze, who has complied with the requirements for the degree Doctor of Philosophy with a thesis titled A Framework for Child Participation in Child-Focused Policy Design in Uganda, prepared under my supervision with the co-supervision of Dr. Kashuya from the University of Nairobi, Kenya. In his thesis, the candidate advocates for an intense cultural and institutional change on how children are comprehensively considered through their participation in child-focused public policy processes. The thesis explored the extent to which Uganda's child-focused policy context promotes multi-stakeholder coordination through an investigation of the synergies between the Ministry of Gender, the National Children's Authority and AfriChild Center as the lead agency in the implementation of the National Child Policy 2020. Using qualitative research methods, the findings indicate that government needs to recognize inherent failures of coordination and integration between stakeholders in the design and implementation of the current National Child Policy. The thesis proposes identification of well-defined child-focused monitoring and evaluation indicators as a framework to child-focused public policy that continues to challenge child participation in child-focused policy processes. Mr. Vice Chancellor and Principal, I request you to confer the degree on the candidate.
I hereby confer the degree of Doctor of Philosophy with all its associated rights and privileges on the candidate. Congratulations.
Mr. Vice-Chancellor and Principal, the following candidates have complied with all the requirements for the degree Master of Public Administration, Management and Policy. Mokabonkwe Mahoso. Nozibusiso Mavuso Ndlovu. Chantel Fansil. Mr. Vice-Chancellor and Principal, the following candidates have complied with all the requirements for the degree Master of Commerce in Human Resource Management. Gugu Trele. Maria Knussen. Kahleko Madupela. Ziyanda Mashalaba. Bongeka Muyafi. Nomathamsanqa Qiti. In industrial psychology, Morney Bester. Sahira Bana. Deborah Brown. Gabrielle Dos Santos. Chantel Fourie, with distinction. Mr. Vice-Chancellor, I wish to correct myself with distinction for Bester Monet as well, with distinction for Renee Bosman. My apologies. Carol Joubert. Caitlin Martins, with distinction. Mapula Mapepele. John Steven Roberts. Marilee Scholes. Anya Shelters, with distinction. Anisha van der Westhuizen. Catherine Vermeulen. Corlette Vermeulen. In marketing management, Kival Davraj. Elka Dupisani. Nombeko Dube. Catherine Ihu. Alicia Moodley. Riolin Ramsamy. He is awarded for the best master's student in MCOM Marketing Management. Cameron Shatia. Amaholeng Setalohile. Mr. Vice-Chancellor and Principal, the following candidates have complied with all the requirements for the degree Master of Philosophy, Human Resource Management. Lebohang Reputswe. Mr. Vice-Chancellor and Principal, the following candidates have complied with all the requirements for the degree Master of Public Administration. Mukhadi Lepuru. Lerato Maisela. Vuyokazi Mdloko. Yeah. Solofelo Muache. Mamorake Mufuakeng. Sepiki Motlala. Ntabiseng Mulandwa. Aboleleng Munedi. Nokwanda Mutembu. Akim Mutombeni. Dubani Mulautsi. Nyamabuya Mutengwe. Lutendo Nelufule. Temba, Temba Mkomzwayo. Tozama Nontwani. Felicia Ntuli. Vyokazi Pachuleni. Vaneshri Perumal. Leshlokonolo Alfred Pasha. Yolande Pile. Keteni Radziliani. Keteni Radziliani. Funani Sibia. Seneke Klobatla. Mr. Vice Chancellor and Principal, the following candidates have complied with all the requirements for the degree Bachelor of Administration Honours in Public Administration and Management. Varaizo Chokuenga. Piwe Dondolo. Boiseli Dube. Kamva Dukada. Ketsepile Khaburetswe. Kabo Itumeleng. Bokamoso Kwale. Munzwezi Kutama. Refilwe Lisu. Asha Mnyambara with distinction. Zizipo Mabedla. Letabo Maimetsa. Vanessa Mkongele. Malebogo Maluleke. Hazel Mampane. Nyasha Manyame. Tisetso Maripula. Exa Mushlongo. Asindiswe Mini. Matapelo Muliti. Letabo Murodi. Providence Mufunya. Nicolene Perumal with distinction. Kosiane Kwabe. Klosyo Raburete. Lucas Sibilwane. Sekofatso Shole. Otlungwelwa Tape. Bonolo Chabalala. Mr. Vice Chancellor and Principal, the following candidates have complied with all the requirements for the degree Bachelor of Commerce Honours, Human Resource Management and Labour Relations. Elisna Hrobler, with distinction. Chisley Lento. Sisanda Sibanda. Elmay Funfake. In Industrial Psychology, Chloe Schillen. Leandre Gibson. Alicia Jadim. Alicia Javahalal. Tanzila Noah Mohammed, with distinction. Sonali Rachod. Herman Robbenheimer. Musengeli Ravele. Hanka Swat. Shanri Teron, with distinction, and Industrial Psychology Postgraduate Prize for the best overall achievement in the degree BCom Honours Industrial Psychology. Ruan van der Marva. Jamie van Veek. Esmary Watson, with distinction. Annika Veitz. Danielle Whittle. Christy Lee Zeffenbergen. In Marketing Management, Matthew Eskew. Martin Austin. Jessica Bansley. Lizanne Botma. Leonardo Kaha. Tayo Crozer. Sabrina Diagua. Megan DeLange. Pranav Danji. Sabrina Diaz. Shailene Govender. Jade Hrailing. Roma Hassan. Lara Jacobs. Melissa Jadim. Philip Jellick. Isabel Kennedy. Duane Kitching. Kiara Lowe. Tabiso Mabula. Matthew Mishley. Owani Mkize. Kuzai Nachito. Lizel Nachel. Paco Nkadingmeng. Mvelo Nkosi. Barbara Mikhail Pienaar. Melissa Pretorius. Taskeen Sheikh Ahmed. Johan Smit. Serena Smit. Megan Stafford. Elisna Fancil. Margaret Feluyen. Marilee Feluyen. Chloe White with distinction. She's also awarded for the best student in BCom Honors Marketing Management. In Tourism Management, Kabengele Kokola. Honsi Madingwane. Keketso Maudi. Ashley Matongo. Nikaila Naidu. Mpoinshe Ngwenya. Adibao Ravele. Mr. Vice-Chancellor and Principal, the following candidates have complied with all the requirements for the postgraduate diploma in public management. Evelina Amakali with distinction. Jacobine Amutenya with distinction. Jafta Chauke with distinction. Mpo Davana. Usisiwe Dingwan with distinction. Yeah. Thobile Gabela. Mamaki Shabashaba. Lazola Jack. Mwana Mutiane Kadiaka with distinction. Chokozani Kumalo. Dumisile Kuzwayo. William Mafolo with distinction. Homotso Makinta. Tsepo Makinka. Charity Maluka. Mohaholodi Mohami with distinction. Likopo Mohele with distinction. Masa Sylvester Mutadi with distinction. Chikombiso Mukombo with distinction. Fortunate Muyeza with distinction. Zoniselo Nana. Fikile Ngumani. Anthony Neo Ngiapo. Lungile Nkadima with distinction. Sishosonke Nkosi. Kenneth Nkuna. Ketiwe Nsangase. Nchengezeni David Nchuaba with distinction. Wilmore Nshona. Prudence Nyembe. Teboho Ramabua with distinction. Tendo Ramahoma with distinction. Diketseng September with distinction. Sepei Steven Seshuka. Mabisa Silunwane Mujindi with distinction. Joseph Skosana. Mr. Vice Chancellor and Principal, the following candidates have complied with all the requirements for the degree Bachelor of Administration in International Relations. Kasheko Leshaba. Risekho Fetse Mompei. In public administration, Mahlokonolo Mampele, Mampashele, in public management, Akona Lumka. In public management and international relations, Kensani Baloi. Lutendo Baloi. Lesedi Buota. Janine Boyce. Natasha Chow. Let's go! Ashekhang Diale. Raisibe Anna Diale. Nozipho Dlamini. Daniela Dominguez. Zinhle Dube. Hamdi Farah. Alessio Ferreira. Tando Haba. Tokozani Chokwana. Tinaye Des Kamkapa. Jessica Kekana. Mantwa Kekana. Amir Khan. Rachel Kwele. Taira Kunyamani. Karabo Leboho. Pabelo Lekishani. Siretselo Lekotloane. Matsepo Letwale. Naledi Letsoko. Faith Mabaso. Kapono Mofuko. Segofatso Mukwai. Muleku Mahasha. Mashati Majlangu. Zandisile Majlangu with distinction. Nonhlanhla Mashiyase. Rineliwe Maibelu. Amohelang Makamedi. Muhao Makena. Qebisa Bonke Malobane. Matete Mangena. Malton Manyaka. Eugene Mapakela. Kuitsapile Mapeule with distinction. Notando Maseko. Poitumelo Mashigo. Caleb Masina. Ribaune Masisi. Mohadi Mashale. Amokelang Mashaka. Rosina Mazimela. Luleka Mduli. Kia Mohetswe Miri. Yoliswa Mulangeni. Katleko Moto. Dimpo Mushala. Takatso Mushala. Lebohang Mukine. Lehlohonolo Mokoena. Tari Morokwe. Khonsi Musadi. Happiness Mutau. Tandiwe Mtombeni. Kimberly Mugomba. Locha Mungadi. Zakaria Naidu. Stokozile Ngenga. Oratile Nkabeleng. Suleiman Ndlovu. Bongiwe Ndlapo. Bernadine Nivot. Samkeliwe Nkonyana. Cameron November. Bongani Ntombela. Sandiso Mchangese. Ntumeleng Ntsimane. Lirian Pedro. Naunga Piri. Martin Poloma. Refilwe Poso. Pumelela Kwakaza. Abab Kasim. Letabo Rabutapi. Riabeswe Ramufuku. Omishka Reddy. Homotso Sebagwe. Tommy Selepi. Yvette Shezi. Matimba Shiviti. Revive Sibia. Courtney Smith. Nicholas Stevens. Lauren Tabete. Tato Shlakane. Sipo Topisi. Itumeleng Cholo. Antonio Vilankulu. Mr. Vice-Chancellor and Principal, the following candidates have complied with all the requirements for the degree Bachelor of Commerce, Human Resource Management. Shanri Barker. Adele Katua. Selina Dacorte, with distinction, also awarded the Human Resource Management Undergraduate Prize for the best achievement over the 3-year study period in BCom Human Resource Management. Lachelle De Koning, with distinction. Etienne Divert. Matthew Dajian. Kylie Erasmus. Sean Hudes. Lara Hossein, with distinction. Tumo Mahopa. Mampati Matsei. Tristan Modley. Kumo Motsatsing. Tito Nkani. Mutumseni Nkwenya. Yuane Opperman with distinction. Shantae Paul Harry. Megan Robinson. Andre Rist. Jonathan Sachies Selenen. My apologies. Caitlin Sherman. Lindy Smith. Susanna van der Walt. Maxine Whitley. In marketing management, Jessica Albertine. Camila Bass. Caitlin Banahan with distinction. Danae Barnett with distinction. Hilna Bester. Wesley Bredenkamp. Mariska Bredenhan. Joshua Briens. Katia Carreira. Helena Kutsia. Bianca Digovia. Michelle DeFilius. Zanae Fools. Marco Gentle. Luke Gibbon. Oh, Declan Khure with distinction. Robin Hussein. Tamrin Haifele. Nicole Janse van Rensburg. With distinction. Nika Uriansi. Gugu Kumalo. Danielle Klupa with distinction. Hilton Creer. Yayun Liu. Chloe Lord. Donovan Lupepe. Tabiso Mahubane. Danielle Marey. Monica Martins. Lindley Marks. Munya Max. Brandon Mathey. Kaylee McCullough. Jason McKean. Braydon Milliam. Sanel Moller. Kamuechwi Molotsi. Nastasia Montipara. Munaka Mutambi. Mubanga Muyinga. Anij Nagar. Ilonka Nil. Andy Nibor. Faiva Oluwamakinde. Nicola Payne. Kayla Rabi. Samuel Ramdiel. Carla Rix. Tamara Rungesami. Guy Salvar. Declan Skippers. Jody Schick. Michael Schumann. Mpointle Shezi. Letukuhle Sebuku. Andres Smith. Charlize Smith with distinction. Taya Tayob. Rochelle Vanderberg with distinction, also awarded for the best student in BCom Marketing Management. Nadine van der Marve. Ruth van der Marve. Stefanes van der Vault. Johannes van der Venter. Francel van Dijk. Annika van Vuren. Connor Finn. Carissa Fenta. Rudolf Fenta with distinction. Vanya Visahi. Christelle Viermeyer. Drew Williamson. Vice Chancellor and Principal. Mr. Vice Chancellor, I wish to offer some apologies for missed pronunciations, but also for prizes that I missed to read, starting with Nomasamkaka Kriti with distinction for the best achievement in the degree MCOM or MPhil Human Resource Management. In Industrial Psychology Postgraduate Prize for the best achievement in the degree MCOM Industrial Psychology, Besta Morne, with distinction. In Human Resource Management and Labor Relations Postgraduate Prize for the best overall achievement in the degree BCOM Honors Human Resource Management and Labor Relations, Elisna Hrobler, with distinction.
Let us give our graduates a big hand for their hard work and perseverance. And I would now like to ask our graduates to applaud their families, friends, spouses, partners for their support over the years. We have now come to the end of the proceedings. Before we close, I wish to invite all present for refreshments afterwards in the marquees situated in front of the Rembrandt Hall. You are requested to stand for the singing of the national anthem and to remain standing until the assembly has been dissolved and the academic procession has left the auditorium. The words of the national anthem are printed on the inside back cover of the program. Please rise.
Oh,
By the powers vested in me, I hereby dissolve this assembly of the University of Pretoria.